gets the trooper back on the north end of the strip. I wasn't tempted to get a damn banana nut waffle, but I got a Reuben sandwich instead. Got some pumpkin pie latte action going. Iced latte action from Earth Cafe. It's a little weird. It's got a little bit of a weird flavor to it, but it tastes all right. It tastes okay. Today is, what day is it? Oh, Tuesday, the slowest day for poker on the strip. We're approaching the, at least yesterday's sleeping place for the guy in the pink underwear pissing all over the strip. Let's hope I don't see him today. I'm actually in an all right mood. I'll give you $50 if you lick the sidewalk right there where he was laying in his little pink panties. All right, Clubs and I were talking. We have an idea for the fifth anniversary of Trooper Thursday. As of November 10th, Trooper Thursday will be 5 years old. Can you believe that? 5 years of Trooper Thursday at the Westgate? I think the plan is, or the idea is, to do a live stream, a live podcast on the Go Gamble podcast channel on that Thursday. We're gonna set up our cameras, set up microphones, do our normal podcast plus the game. It's gonna be an epic Trooper Thursday live stream on the Go Gamble podcast channel. All right, apparently we got a escaped convict on the loose. Whatever his name is. Something Porfirio Duerta, I don't know, Herrera, some dude escaped from the prison. He's doing life in prison for murder. I guess he had something to do with a pipe bomb in 2007 at the Luxor. I didn't even know that happened, but he escaped from the Southern Desert something correctional something. Should we skip poker and go out there and look for him? Honestly, I don't think I'll have to go look for him. He's probably playing poker at the Venetian right now, trying to hit a high hand. Just a little break from the game. First of all, it's freezing in my seat. At my table, it's freezing. Second of all, this dude right here, there's a dude over here having a full-blown conversation by himself. But I heard him say, "Where did I go wrong?" That explains the solo conversation. So I'm about to be really hard on myself for something. I don't know how I can expect myself to know everything on the strip, where everything is, and whenever a new coffee place opens. But that Dandelion small batch chocolate joint just opened. I guess it's new. I mean, it has to be somewhat new. But I got a coffee from in there, and check this out. It comes with a little biscuit on the side, a little thing. How cool is that? Look at that little, in America we call it a cookie, but they probably call it a biscuit, right? I had to get the house mocha. I don't normally get a cafe mocha, but I had to get the house mocha because it's a chocolate place. Lady Trooper loves chocolate. She gonna have to come back to Dandelion. Let's check this coffee out. You ready? I see where the lady was going. She said their mocha that they use, they make the mocha with a 70% cocoa dark chocolate. That's nice. It's definitely a dark chocolate thing going on there. Got some new coffee action at the Venetian. Genesis before. Funny story from the table tonight with a moral. Guy raises, guy three bets him right on his left. Original raiser calls, they see the flop heads up. There's a bet and a call on the flop. They check the turn and the river, there's a small bet and a call. The original raiser had pocket kings. The three better had pocket aces. They didn't make a huge pot, but here's the point. The dealer, nice guy. Decent dealer, no real complaint, and I don't believe the dealer meant anything by it. You know that if I thought the dealer meant something by it, I would say it, because I just say it. I don't hold back. So I really don't think this dealer meant anything by it, but as he was pushing the pot, the dealer said, wow, you got lucky to not lose more with that. I'm gonna tell you the moral of the story. The moral of the story is the dealers shouldn't be speaking up about things like this unless they're invited into it somehow. There are a few things wrong with what the dealer said. I mean, first of all, the guy to whom the dealer was speaking, the guy with kings, did not look happy about what the dealer said. He did not take any sort of comfort in the fact that he could have lost more with kings against aces. He didn't care what the dealer's opinion was. I sort of took a peek at the dealer after he said it, and it almost looked like the dealer realized that he probably shouldn't have said that. Not that it was entirely offensive or anything, but you really just shouldn't interject anything in here. On the other side of the coin, the guy who won the pot, the guy with aces, is being reminded and alerted to the fact that, hey, you could have won a lot more with that. So the guy with aces is the guy who's about to tip you because he won the pot. It's just not a good idea. It's not a good idea whatsoever. The moral of the story is that if you're a dealer, you should really stay impartial, and you really shouldn't say anything, because even if your intentions are good, there is a great chance, especially with poker players, that the person you're speaking to is not going to take it the way you meant it, and ultimately, you should just be quiet. Not to be rude, but you just shouldn't say anything like that. It kind of falls under the same category as good luck all in. Remember eons ago when I made a video about dealers saying good luck all in? No dealer ever should say good luck all in. It's generally annoying to dealers when players blame dealers for their bad luck or for a card coming or not coming or winning or losing a pot. It's annoying to dealers, and rightfully so, because the dealer doesn't have anything to do with it. But when a dealer says good luck all in, the dealer is now wishing luck to one player over another. You just shouldn't do it. It's a bad look. It's bad for your pocketbook. It's bad for business. It's bad for poker. It's bad for everything. It's just not, nothing against the dealer. I don't think he meant anything by it. This is a lesson. to any poker dealer who might be watching this. This is all just advice. You are welcome to take that advice and tell me to stick it straight up my ass. Ignore it, but it's good advice. I lose 122 for the night. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'm gonna see you next time.